Mama Bear pleads to man to save her drowning cubs. Animals and humans are often put one against each other despite the fact that there's an entire range of emotions they could share. We got inevitably a bit detached from nature due to our everyday lives, technology, and the internet surrounding us. So sometimes nature has to give us a little reminder for us to truly appreciate and acknowledge the emotions wild animals are capable of feeling and showing. That's exactly what happened to these fishermen while they were having just another regular day in their boat. A small reminder, just when they were ready to bring some fish back to their homes, they saw three drowning bears in the lake waters. But that wasn't everything that happened to them. When they decided to get closer to the mama bear and her two bear cubs in order to save them, something incredible occurred that they couldn't even imagine in their wildest dreams. It all happened at Lake Vigosero in Russia. It is one of the most beautiful northern areas of the country, but it has one of the harshest weathers too. The lake often battles with freezing temperatures that form ice on the surface of the lake. When the lake is covered in ice, the entire area becomes a danger zone that people avoid visiting during winter months. However, some animals don't really have a choice, so they have to stay in the closeness of the lake and wait for the cold to pass. The cold was approaching, and it was clear to animals that they should now retreat and hide in their carefully picked shelters. That's just what one mama bear wanted to do with her three bear cubs, so she tried everything she could in order to get them across a nearly frozen lake to get to the safer side. She, in the end, decided to jump in the lake and hope that her cubs will be strong enough to keep up with her strong leg. Unfortunately, it became soon clear that cubs won't make it across the other side with their mother. Animals can sometimes be quite cruel, and so was this mama bear. She gave up on carrying her cubs, and instead she started swimming, by her own, to the other side of the lake, leaving her poor cubs alone in the freezing water. Although their mom needed to do such a thing because the current was pulling them away from their mom, the cubs were really scared. Their bodies were thrown throughout the freezing water, and they couldn't fight the strong current that was overpowering them. Small bear cubs were lost in the water, alone and freezing in the cold weather conditions. You could easily tell they didn't even know how to swim properly and that they were frightened to death. But they also had some luck in all this mess. Help will soon be in their sight. The little bear cubs being dragged downstream by the currents in the end wasn't such a bad thing. In the deep waters of the lake, there was a fishing boat whose fishermen immediately spotted the frightened bear cubs. The fishermen paddled straight towards them as soon as they saw the poor cubs. It seemed that the cubs also gave their best to swim towards the fishing boat as soon as they realized that there was something approaching them. Fishermen initially wanted to grab the bear cubs out of the water and keep them safe. But when they got close to them, they spotted the mama bear standing at the side of the lake, gazing toward them. Although she wasn't swimming in their direction, they still didn't want to trigger her motherly instincts and make her think they are enemies. The fishermen agreed that they needed to wait for the right moment before saving the cubs from the water. They wanted to make sure the mama bear would be at a good distance when they were getting the little bears out of the freezing lake. The fishermen were slightly frightened about what was going to happen. However, they knew that they had to help these poor cubs out. One of them thought that filming the entire action would be a good idea. So they got really close and were now thinking how to get the cubs inside the boat. But before they could even think of a solution, the little bear grabbed the side of the boat and was trying to lift himself up inside. The fisherman wanted to let the cub hop in by itself, but it seemed that the little bear didn't have enough strength to lift himself up into the boat. It was such a difficult thing to watch, a poor bear struggling for his life and seeking help from a complete stranger. The fisherman now wanted really bad to protect the poor cubs and help them get on board, but it was easier said than done. They were still hoping that they will manage to get into the boat on their own, but the more time passed, the more unlikely did that seem. The fishermen felt so sorry for the little bears, and they couldn't just watch them struggling in the freezing water anymore. They were now thinking if they could reach down and grab the bears, would that be a good idea? As much as they wanted to help them, they were also afraid that the bear cubs would see them as a threat and attack them out of fear. Still, they knew that they needed to do something to save them. They now wanted to be sure that they'll gain the trust of the little abandoned bear cubs. Once the fishermen could be certain that the bears didn't see them as a threat, everything would become much easier. The fishermen were trying to think of the best solution for this rare situation they found themselves in, and the bears were still dealing with the frozen waters and the strong lake's current. In one particular moment, one fisherman was thinking about how strange it would be found in a situation like this one, And in one moment, just as if the bear cub could see his thoughts, the fisherman found himself looking directly into the eyes of the bear cub, and the bear cub was looking back at him. It seemed that the two agreed upon the situation and decided to work together. The bear cubs wanted to be saved, and the fishermen wanted to help them. So now they had to work together in order to achieve it, and it seemed the cubs understood it. When the little bear cub realized that it was too hard to lift himself up, he got frightened. It seemed like the bear wanted more than ever to be close to the boat. Luckily, the bear cub discovered a way to stay close to the fisherman without having to lift himself into the boat. He used his strong teeth and stuck them into the side of the boar. With his strong bite, he held himself out of the water and managed to stay by the side of the boat. They were aware that reaching down and grabbing the bears out of the water wasn't the best idea. In the end, those were still wild animals and weren't used to having a human in their close environment. Fishermen were now trying to find the right plan that will help them rescue the cubs from the water. They started thinking about the tools they had that could be useful for the situation, and they found something on board that could come in handy, the fisherman's net. It seemed quite unlikely that their new plan would work, but they had nothing else to try. In the end, using a net to get the two bear cubs from the water would really sound like a silly idea to anyone aware of the fact how heavy bear cubs are, and how difficult it is to get drowning cubs from the water, but the fishermen decided to give it a try. Getting two small bears out of the water was indeed a much more complicated job than catching small batches of fish. However, the fishermen were persistent and decided they will somehow get these cubs out of the water. They were aware that what they decided to do was going to be a tough job, but they had no choice now. They couldn't leave them in the water just like that now, and they were so close. So they decided to slowly approach bears once again and have their net prepared. First, the fishermen had to get their net around the first cub. When they finally managed it, they started to pull him closer to the boat. They had to be very attentive because the net could have been broken due to the weight of the bear. They were afraid of it happening because then, the cub would go back into the cold depths. Who knows what could happen to the poor bears? They were exhausted from the cold and didn't have a lot of energy to continue their struggle in the frozen lake. Even if it looked like the cub trusted the fishermen, they still wanted to make sure that the baby bears won't attack them. So they needed to think of a way to maintain their trust while they were rescuing them. The fishermen tried to calm the bears by speaking to them softly and having an unthreatening demeanor. But would that work with bear cubs? They could only hope everything would go the right way. Now the fishermen had nothing else to do but reel in the net. As they pulled, for the first time, they realized how heavy the cub actually was. Although they didn't weigh 1,300 pounds like other bears, they were still very heavy for the fishermen to pull them out easily. Additionally, the freezing water made them even heavier than they really were. The fishermen were pulling and pulling, but they couldn't get the first cub into the boat. They tried everything, pulling with more force, pulling with less force, pulling from different angles. But most of the things they tried just seemed as completely useless action. They even thought at some point they weren't destined to rescue the poor cubs and wondered if they should just give up. The fishermen slowly lost hope while they were trying to pull out the bear. They used up all of their strength to bring the cub above water, but nothing seemed to work enough. They decided not to give up and took one last shot to get the bear onto the boat. Luckily, this time the first cub came much closer to the boat. The fishermen knew they were incredibly close. The fishermen had to lift the net at least a dozen times before managing to get the first cub on the boat. Now they had an even more complicated situation. The second cub was still in the freezing water, and the first cub was now on their boat. What scared them now was the fact that they didn't know how the first cub would react. Would it stay calm on the boat and wait for the fisherman to save his brother? They could only hope nothing could go wrong. The fishermen now had a frightened cub on their boat, but had to save the other one too. But the problem was that both cubs and fishermen were really tired now from everything that was going on. They also had to make sure the rescued cub would stay calm on the boat and not cause some mess that could make this whole rescue action end terribly. However, fishermen were determined to save the other cub too, no matter what. Having already rescued one baby cub, the fishermen knew exactly what they needed to do. The only problem was that it still wasn't a really easy task to do. So they were first trying to get the bear cub closer to the boat. Luckily, the bear had enough energy to reach the boat. By getting closer to the fisherman's boat, the baby bear made the whole action plan much easier. They cast their net one more time and grabbed the other cub too. Now they knew better what they were doing, but still, they needed to pull really hard to get the other baby bear near them. Despite being really exhausted, the second rescue went more smoothly. Maybe the second cub was calmer because he knew his little brother was waiting for him on the boat. Who knows? Soon, the two bear cubs were on the boat, safe from the freezing water and happy to be with one another. But the fishermen had another doubt now. Now that they saved the cubs, what are they going to do with them? They were also a bit scared to have two bear cubs on the boat. If the bear just thought the fishermen looked like a threat rather than a friend, their existence would be at a high risk. Even if the cubs were happy to be saved from the freezing water, they were in a state of shock at the time. They were shaking from the cold and the fear, but they still were showing respect to their saviors by staying calm. The fishermen were also very careful with the little cubs. They didn't want to scare them out now that they finally managed to get them out of the lake, but they had another thing to resolve now. The fishermen found themselves in a strange situation. All they were thinking about was how to rescue the little cubs, but they hadn't thought about what they were going to do once the cubs were saved. Also, they had no idea how long they could keep the bears calm on their boat. The weather conditions were really harsh, and they had to leave them in a place where they would have warm shelter. The fishermen knew they had to leave the cubs in a safe area, and they were thinking of the best place they could find. They wanted to reunite the cubs with their mom. But how could they know where the mama bear was now? They couldn't see her anywhere from the boat, so they started thinking of all the times they saw the mama bear in the lake surroundings. The fishermen started driving around in order to find the perfect spot for the little bears. Soon they remembered that the mama bear lived on a small island off the lake, and that even though she left them before, she would still start looking for her cubs soon. After cruising around for a while, the fishermen finally agreed that they found the place where the mama bear probably lived. Although there was no sign of her, they were still pretty sure that she would find her lost cubs in this place. It was really hard for the fishermen to say goodbye to the little cubs now, but knew that this was the only right thing to do. They finally made their way to the island and carried the bear cubs to the land. The fishermen bonded with two lovely cubs, and in fact, it looked like two cubs didn't want to leave the men that saved them. Eventually, they let go and went on to look for their mother. The fisherman was astounded that the little bears showed so much love toward them, in the end by being reluctant to leave them. At first, they thought the little bears could attack them, but now they were showing their gratefulness in the most wonderful way. However, they are wild animals, and they needed to stay in the wild, so they continued to look for their mom. The fishermen were touched by everything that happened that day, and learned how affectionate wild animals can be when approached with love and care. They will never forget this amazing